This is Vivek here, and today in this video we will be modeling an SCR and we will see how does it works. An SCR stands for Silicon-controlled Rectifier. It's a power electronic device or a power electronic switch where once the gate supply if given, the switch always remains turned on, and even if you put the gate supply off or even if you turn off the gate supply, the switch still remains in conduction mode. So it is also known as semi-controlled switch. That is, you can only turn it on but there is no way you can turn it off. Definitely there are different techniques, different commutation techniques, but I'm not talking about that. I'm comparing this operation to different switches like in IGBT or in GTO, where you can turn off the switch by turning off the gate supply. But in SCR that doesn't happen. The conduction of an SCR continues even if the gate supply is not there. So how does that happen? We will see with the help of transistors. We will model an SCR and we will see why does such a behavior is shown by an SCR. So for modeling an SCR, we will be using an NPN bipolar transistor, okay, and a PNP bipolar transistor, okay. Now let me make a circuit. So first of all, I will make use of this PNP type transistor and let me rotate it like this, okay. So the emitter terminal remains at the top and the collector at the bottom, and this transistor I will put it like this, okay. Now connect this point of the PNP type transistor to the base of the NPN type transistor, and collector of the NPN type transistor is connected to the base of the PNP type transistor. So this is basically the SCR we are talking about. This constitutes an SCR. Let me make it a bit down, okay. Now let me show you how does it constitutes an SCR. For that we will be using, for test purpose, definitely this DC supply is required, and we will be using an LED. So we will see that this LED is basically nothing but an load. So on this the experiment will be done. We will be seeing how this LED will behave with the help of these two transistors which are simulating an SCR, okay. Let me use some resistors to control the voltage, okay, and a push button. Now put this here. We will first of all connect a resistor to this point. A 1 kilo ohm resistor will be connected to the PNP type transistor, and a 1 kilo ohm with the help of this switch. This switch is what will help us to trigger the SCR, okay. Just like in SCR there is a switch for the gate terminal which will just turn it on, okay. Now we will connect it to here. So this junction or this point behaves as the gate terminal of an SCR. This behaves as an SCR, this hole, and this is the gate terminal. Now just connect all of them in parallel like this to the supply. 1 volt is very less. Let us make it 10 volt, okay, and this will be connected to earth, that is the emitter, and the LED will be connected over here, okay. So basically if you keep the figure in mind, what is happening, the SCR, let's say this is the SCR, this is the collector point of the SCR, okay. So the LED is over here. So if the if this is gated, if the SCR is gated, the LED will the SCR will help the current to drive through the LED and the LED will glow. Now let us see how it works. First of all, connect this here, okay. So the circuit is complete. Now let us see how it behaves. Just put this to 500 ohm, okay. Now let me run this. Initially everything is at off state, nothing is conducting, but when I push this button, that is I given the trigger, you can see after giving the trigger this switch is open. Still the LED is glowing. And now I have no control over the state of the SCR. No matter how much I give the gate pulse, or even the gate pulse is off or on, it doesn't matter, the LED still remains on. So this behaves as an SCR. To turn it off, there are various commutation techniques, class A, class B techniques, class C techniques, various techniques are there, but we are not discussing today here. Now, how does this model actually helps us to simulate an SCR? Because you can see that even if I press the button, there is no effect on the operation. Let me describe you what happens actually. Initially, everything is off, and when I push this button, that is when I give this trigger, what is happening? The current from the voltage source, that is the 10 volt supply, flows through here, okay, and it is applied to the gate terminal of the NPN type transistor. As a result, as the NPN type transistor is gated, the collector emitter junction behaves as a short circuit, and the current through the LED, through this resistor, through the LED, it flows to the earth. So this behaves as a complete path. Okay, now another thing what is happening is that a PNP type transistor turns on when it receives negative pulse at its gate terminal. Okay, so what is happening when this behaves as a short circuit, at that instant of time, the negative potential from this point comes over here, okay, because as it is a short circuit, as this collector emitter is short circuited ideally, so the negative potential appears over here, and this negative potential eventually gives the gate supply to the PNP type transistor. As a result, the PNP type transistor also short circuits, that is the collector emitter behaves as a short circuited path. Okay, that is in ideal case. So as this behaves as a short circuit, what happens? This 10 volt supply supplies current through 1 kilo ohm through this PNP type transistor, and the current flows through this to the gate terminal of the NPN type transistor. Okay, so basically what is happening over here is that the NPN type transistor is helping the PNP type transistor to drive, and the PNP type transistor is driving the NPN type transistor. How? Because once the gate supply has been given through here, that is once I have supplied to the gate current comes over here, the NPN type transistor turns on, and as a result it short circuits. Because of the short circuiting, the negative potential rises up here and it turns on the PNP type transistor, and the PNP type transistor draws current from the 10 volt supply and it supplies it to the gate terminal of the NPN type transistor. So you can see these two transistors are complementing each other, that is helping each other to drive. Okay, and that's why there is no need of this switch, because the need of this switch was to trigger the gate terminal of the NPN type transistor, but now what is happening, the gate is being triggered with the help of this, or the continuous trigger to the gate terminal of the NPN type transistor is being done by the PNP type transistor. Moreover, this complementary effect, or the complementing transistor, these two transistors are complementing each other, this is also known as latching in electronics. Okay, so this is in latch mode, and no matter whatever I do externally, there is no effect. The load, whatever load that has been connected, will still remain turned on. So this is how an SCR works, and this is how we model an SCR. I will leave the link to this simulation in the description down below. You can go to that link and you can check it out. Use Chrome browser, because the simulator that I am using is an online simulator and it works in Google Chrome. So I will recommend that you use this simulator in Google Chrome, or you can use this circuit and simulate it anywhere. Okay, so basically it also helps us to simulate an SCR if there is no SCR in your simulator. So you can simulate an SCR by using the model of this two transistor, that is an NPN and PNP type transistor. So I hope this video was quite helpful for you, and it gave you a conceptual clarity about how does an SCR works like that, how does it shows such a behavior. If this video was helpful for you, please share with your friends, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel, and also share your feedback in the comment section below. This is Vivek Choubey signing off. Thank you.